Hey James, this is your laser engraver. We'd like to do a video for everyone. We test everyone to make sure they're working properly. I just want to show you. It's gonna reset now. So while it's doing that, I'm gonna show you over here. You can see the serial number on it. Make sure you see this is your one we just sent you. Show you that it does work correctly. It's 201-106-30006. It's your serial number. You can look in here and you can see some characteristics. Just so you know that this is the one we sent you, but anyway, you got some tears in there. This stuff comes off. It's just a protective coating. Some marks there. And, see anything else? And, this thing will reset and move here when it's ready. And this thing comes off too, right there. That's nothing there. You can see that right there, but just, this thing peels off to show it. And on the bottom underneath of it, too. We do have this one mark here. This is a new unit, but they sometimes get little scuff marks during just the assembly process. I'm gonna just show you how. One of the things when these tubes that you can see, there's a demonstration video. These things no longer have water flow sensors because of too many problems with them. So you just have to make sure you always have water, cold water. Usually ice cold water. There was ice in this. It's kind of mostly melted, but it's probably about 45 degree water. You like to keep it under 60 degrees if possible, the water. If it gets too hot, like over 70, it'll crack your laser tube. So make sure you keep an eye on your water, keep adding ice and stuff like that. We will have some water coolers available shortly if you ever want to buy one. That way you don't have to worry about it. But anyway, this hose here, the yellow one, it goes to your water pump. It takes a little while to work it down into that, but you just keep pushing down into it. It's kind of a tight fit on that piece there, but I'll have to take it off to shift it. But anyway, I've already installed the LaserWorks software here. I'm going to open it up, and there it is. I'm just going to do a couple quick things. Let's do let's do a square box. I'll just start it. I put it right there. I'll do a circle too. Doesn't really matter where you put this on here. It's going to start from where the laser head is. Okay, I've only got the one selected, so edit. I think it's select all. So I'm going to select all. Okay, again, I'm both selected, and then I'm going to hit this start button. I got it set to speed 200 power, 25%. But I'm going to hit this start button. Before that, we'll go put this down in here, and you can just watch it from here. Unfortunately, this thing's in the way, but you just got to keep this lid closed. But as you can see, there's nothing on this cardboard. And I'll just lay it right under here like this and just stay there and watch it. You probably won't be able to see it, but I'll hit the start button over here. And there, it just did it real quick. As you can see, it did the square and the circle. We'll go over here and I'll do one more. Just keep it on the same side. I'll put an image right there of a bird. Go back here. I'll undo these just to get rid of it. Looks like I need to undo it again. Okay, they're both gone now. And I've already imported something to my desktop right here, this bird peace sign here. And I'm just gonna, I think it's a bitmap file. And let's see. Wrong one. Import. And there from my desktop right here. And there's the peace sign there. Open. Okay, it's gonna show it real big. It just blew it up. You can use your roller on your mouse to back this back off to where you can have it see the whole table. Oops. Get rid of that. And let's see here. I need to get the pointer over here in the corner. It's been a while since I missed this. I forgot how to drag this up. I'm not going to take the time now. You'll figure it out. It's pretty simple, but well, there's a way to drag this up here. So I have to recenter it. I've messed with this in a long time. Oh, this here. This hand. Okay. Now I can recenter it. Okay. Now, I'm going to go back to the pointer. it's selected here. No, it wasn't. Now I said if it wasn't selected, it wouldn't work. So I had to select it. Now I'm going to go over here and click the start button right there. And just go back to the machine here before I click it. I'll show you again. There's that thing. It's just, I'll put it right there. Just put it right under it. It's going to start right where it's at, no matter where you put it on that table up there on your computer. And hit click start. This will take a little bit more because it's a little bit more of a scan. And it is a BMP file. It'll do other ones too, like JPEG and stuff. But I think BMP black and white files are usually the best to do on these things. Should take more than 30 seconds or so. That one's set to speed 100, power 20%. We do have another video. You can watch to learn a little bit more about this, and also a video on the software if you haven't already watched it. I don't want to open this lid because you're supposed to keep them closed. You can see as it's operating, that laser indicator will be blinking. As you can see, it works very well. And that's what it engraved. And as you can see over here, well, I'll go back here one more time. So those images and things, everything's working great on it. Well, blow this up and put it back to that hand to drag us in the right spot. Now, where'd that go right there? Getting dizzy here. There it is. But also, you know, this is a Windows 7. This is just a Windows 7 Home Premium, 64-bit Premium. I'm not sure where it is, but here's System Properties. And this is the typical computer these work with, Windows 7 Home Premium. Right there, 64-bit operation down here. So that's the computer we recommend for it, but it will work on like XP Home too. All right, I'll send this video to you just so you can see. I'm gonna clean it up and pack it up and everything. But we do, like I said, we do open up every one of these and test it. Because it's just, if there was a slight problem with it, it's just too expensive to have them shipped back. So we want to make sure everything's working perfect before we send it. And I just wanted you to have this video so you can see it in action. And then it is working perfect. We'll get it packed up and get it shipped out. It's probably going to be Friday morning before we can get it out. This is Thursday afternoon, late Thursday afternoon right now.